Hi everyone, today we will discuss regarding flight adaptations in birds. In this topic, we will go through the following objectives: adaptation definition, morphological adaptations, anatomical adaptations. Adaptation definition: any alteration in the structure or function of any organism or any of its part that results from natural selection and by which the organism becomes better fitted to survive and multiply in its environment, that is called as adaptation. That is nothing but it is showing adjustment with new environment or habitat. Greater the degree of adaptation, more is the deviation from the normal morphology. So this is the definition of adaptation. The birds mainly shows two types of adaptation to fly in the air. Those adaptations are called as aerial adaptations or flight adaptations that favors the birds to fly in the air. The first adaptation is the morphological adaptation. Second one is anatomical adaptations. Morphological adaptations: the birds show certain modifications or adjustments in their external structure that permits the birds to show aerial mode of life. The first morphological adaptation is body contour. So to minimize the resistance offered by air during flight, the body of the birds, it is fusiform or spindle shaped. Fusiform or spindle shaped, and it lacks any other extra projection. So this offers resistance in the attainment of speed in air, like fish in a water. So body contour, this is the first morphological adaptation. Second one, that is compact body. The body, it is light and strong dorsally, heavy ventrally, which helps in maintaining the equilibrium in the air. The attachment of the wings, it is high in position on the thorax. The high position of the light organs like lungs and air sacs, and low central position of the heavy muscles, sternum and digestive organs. The attachment of both the wings and consequently low the center of the gravity are the morphological facts of great significance. So this is the second morphological adaptation, that is compact body. Third one, body covering of feathers. So body of all birds, it is covered by special integumentary derivatives that are called as feathers. The feathers are the characteristic feature of birds, not at all seen in any animals all over the animal kingdom. So the feathers, if you see that, they are having the following advantages for birds that favors to fly in the air. The feathers are smooth, closely fitting and backwardly directed. Contour feathers make the body streamlined, helping them to pass through the air by reducing the friction to the minimum. So the feathery covering makes the body light, and at the same time it will protect from the environmental hazards like temperature. The feathers hold a considerable blanket of enveloping air around the body and adds much to its buoyancy. The non-conducting covering of the feathers, it will insulate the body perfectly. That means it will prevent the loss of body temperature. That means it will prevent the loss of heat and helps in maintaining the normal constant body temperature. So which enable the birds to endure intense cold at high altitudes and also to maintain a constant body temperature. The feathers of wings form a broad surface for striking the air. So these are the different types of feathers. So this is one of the morphological adaptation. The fourth morphological adaptation, that is the four limbs, they are modified into wings. The four limbs have transformed into powerful and propelling organs that are called as wings. The wings are the sole organs of a flight. These organs have framework of bones, muscles, nerves, blood vessels, feathers, etc. So both wings spring from the anterior region of the trunk. During rest, they remain folded against the sides of the body, but during flight, they will become expanded. So the surface of the area of the wings, it is increased by the development of elongated flight feathers that are called as remiges. The vein of each remixes form a flexible and continuous surface for striking the air in flight. The flight feathers of a wing also forms a broad surface for supporting the bird in air. So the particular shape of a wing with thick, strong leading edge, that is nothing but the upper surface of the wing will be the convex in nature, and the lower surface of the wings will have concave surface that will causes the reduction in the air pressure above and increases the pressure below with minimum turbulence behind. So this helps in driving the bird forwards and upwards during flight. The fifth morphological adaptation, that is mobile neck and head. The transformation of forelimbs into wings is duly compensated by the presence of beak or bill used for feeding, nest building, preening and offense and defense. The mouth, it is drawn out into a horny beak, which acts as a pair of forceps in picking up the things and in various other activities such as nest building, pruning, etc., which are normally done by forelimbs in other animals. So the neck in birds is also very long and flexible for the movement of the head necessary for various functions. The sixth morphological adaptation, that is the bipedal locomotion. As anterior part of the body of the birds become concerned with flight, the posterior parts of the body becomes modified for movement on land. So for locomotion on the ground and to support the entire body weight, the hind limbs occupy a somewhat anterior position on the trunk and become stouter in case of ratites, which are running birds. So this is the sixth morphological adaptation. Perching. The seventh morphological adaptation is perching. The hind limbs of the bird are well specialized for an arboreal life. Their muscles are developed in such a manner that when a bird sits on a branch of a tree, the toes close around the twig automatically. So this happens due to the called perching mechanism. So when the bird settles on a branch of a tree, the legs are bent and put the flexor tendons on the stretch. With the exertion of the pull, the toes are bent spontaneously around the perch, so that a bird, it can go to sleep in this position without any fear or falling off. The next morphological adaptation, the last one, that is the short tail. The short tail of the bird bears a tuft of long tail feathers that are called as retrices, which will spread out in a fan-like manner and serves as a rudder during flight. They also assist in steering, lifting and counterbalancing during flying and perching. So all these are the morphological adaptations that are shown by the birds to fly in the air. Anatomical adaptations. Anatomical adaptations. The flying birds have following anatomical modifications for aerial life. The first anatomical adaptation, that is the flight muscles. So the action of the wings, it is controlled by the flight muscles, which are greatly developed, weighing at about 1/6 of the entire body of the bird. while the muscles on the back remain greatly reduced. The muscle fibers comprising the flight muscles are striated type and they are vascularized and they can withstand the fatigueless after prolonged activity. The wings are depressed by large muscles that are called as pectoralis major and elevated by pectoralis minor. So other muscles are small and help the above muscles in their functioning. So the wings are depressed by pectoralis major and elevated by pectoralis minor. The second anatomical adaptation, that is the lightness and rigidity of endoskeleton. The skeletal framework of flying birds is very stout and it is lightly built on the hollow girder principle. So most of the bones are pneumatic bones which are filled with air and provided with the secondary plastering to make them rigid. The bone marrow, it is completely absent in the bones of birds. Further, the skeletal framework, it will become compact, centralized, rigid due to the fusion of bones. So due to presence of pneumatic bones and absence of bone marrow in the bones and due to the fusion of bones, it may give more rigidity to the skeletal system that favors the birds to fly in the air. Endoskeleton of birds. The skull bones are paper-like, thin and show a tendency towards the reduction in the number. That means the skull bones are reduced in number. These bones are firmly fused with each other. So the posterior portion of the skull, it is spongy in nature. Teeth are completely absent in birds. The next one, all the thoracic vertebrae except the last are fused to a single mass, giving rigidity to the dorsal part of the vertebral column. So the fusion of vertebrae provides a firm fulcrum for the action of the wings in striking the air. So the uncinate process of the thoracic ribs provides the compactness which is necessary for flight. The arched clavicles are fused with the interclavicles and powerful pillar-like coracoids of the pectoral girdle are well suited to resist the inward pressure of the downstroke. The vertebrae are heterocoelous vertebrae which will give great flexibility and birds, they can move their neck at about 180 degrees centigrade. It helps in preening the feathers in all parts of the body. So the shortening of the caudal vertebrae and the formation of the pygostyle, it has assisted stability in air. So this is related to endoskeleton of birds. Sternum or breastbone, it is expanded and having a median ridge or keel for the attachment of flight muscles in flying birds, while it is without keel in running birds like ostrich. So the sternum, it is hollow in which the viscera are located. The fusion of the pelvis with synsacrum, that is nothing but fusion of the lost thoracic vertebrae, lumbar and sacral vertebrae and a few anterior caudal vertebrae, they will fuse with each other to form a single structure that is called a synsacrum. It not only supports the weight of the body when the bird it is walking, but also counteracts the effects of shock as the bird alights. So the absence of ventral symphysis of ischia and pubis permits the laying of large eggs. The fusion of digital tarsals with the metatarsals to form a tarsometatarsus and the proximal tarsals with the lower end of the tibia to form tibiotarsus that helps to strengthen the legs for bipedal gait. The skeleton of four limbs is completely modified for attachment of the feathers, that is remiges and flight muscles. So there are only three digits which are more or less fused. So presence of synsacrum Torsometatarsus, Tibiotarsus. And digits with the three number, these are some of the adaptations. Next, anatomical adaptations that is related to digestive system. Next one is the digestive system. So the rate of metabolism in birds is very high. So the food requirements are great and digestion it is rapid. So most birds are very selective in their diet. And accordingly, their beaks are variously modified. So further, because undigested waste is minimum and it is immediately got rid of. So consequently, the rectum, it will becomes more reduced in length and never stores the undigested food. This is one of the adaptation, that is the rectum, it is reduced in length and it never stores the undigested food. Another one is the ill development or poor development of the rectum of flying birds indicates towards the fact that the flying birds, they cannot afford to bear the weight of the feces. Absence of gallbladder, that will minimize the body weight. So the digestive system, reduction in the size of the rectum and absence of the gallbladder that favors the birds to fly. So this is adaptations that are shown by the digestive system. Respiratory system. So the respiratory system, it is also showing certain modifications that favors the birds to fly. So the flying birds require a great and sustained power, therefore its respiratory system is specialized in such a fashion that the food is combusted rapidly and completely to liberate large amount of energy. So to meet the extensive rate of metabolism, greater amount of oxygen molecule is needed by the body tissues. So here in birds we can see dense, compact and inelastic lungs that are supplemented by a remarkable system of air sacs. That means lungs associated air sacs are present, which are grown out from the lungs and occupy all available spaces between the internal organs and even extending into the cavities of the hollow bones. So the air sacs primarily reduces the specific gravity of the bird and also facilitate the complete aeration of the lungs. So the avian lungs are aerated twice at each breath, which secures the perfect oxygenation of blood. That's why in aves we can see the double respiration. The air sacs help in regulating the body temperature by internal perspiration. The insertion of the air sacs in between the flight muscles acts like that of the pads and reduces the mechanical friction and increases the mobility in muscular action. So here we can see the respiratory system in birds, which are having the two compact inelastic lungs that are associated with that of the air sacs. Circulatory system, the fifth anatomical adaptation, that is circulatory system. The rapid metabolism requires large oxygen supply to the tissue, which can be achieved by an efficient circulatory system. So in birds we can see completely divided chamber, four chambered heart with complete double circulation. So the heart in aves, it is large sized, completely divided four chambered heart, which is powerful and efficient. So due to double circulation, the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood remains completely separated. Further, the red blood cells of the birds, they will contain large amounts of hemoglobin, which is responsible for quick and perfect aeration of body tissue. So these are adaptations related to circulatory system. And the sixth anatomical adaptation, that is warm-bloodedness. So due to perfect aeration of the blood, the body temperature remains high, that is at about 40 to 46 degrees centigrade, 40 degrees centigrade to 46 degrees centigrade, and it does not change with the change of the environmental temperature. For this reason, the birds are called as warm-blooded or homeothermal animals or thermoregulators. The high and constant body temperature enables the birds to take flight at high altitudes and also facilitates the activeness in every season. So the birds are homeotherms or thermoregulators, which can maintain the constant body temperature at about 40 degrees to 46 degrees centigrade. So the high and constant body temperature enables the birds to take flight at high altitudes and also facilitates activeness in every season. So this is the sixth anatomical adaptation. Let us go for the next anatomical adaptation related to excretory system. So for the retention of the water, the uriniferous tubules with Henle's loop are efficient in water absorption. The coprodium of cloaca, it is another efficient organ that absorbs the water. For reducing the weight of the body, urinary bladder is absent, and the excretory product, it will be sent in the form of semi-solid pellets that are called as uric acid and urates. So here the body weight, it is reduced due to absence of urinary bladder, and the metabolic nitrogen wastes are converted into less toxic insoluble organic compounds such as uric acid and urates, which plays an important physiological adaptation. The eighth anatomical adaptation, which is related to nervous system. So here brain and sense organs. The avian brain, if you see that, it is highly developed, consisting of well-developed centers of equilibrium, muscular coordination and instinct. The cerebellum is much developed and convoluted, controlling the sense of equilibrium and muscular coordination. So the cerebrum, it is also larger and relatively smooth, controlling the voluntary movements, behavior, intelligence and memory. So the birds have to depend most on the sense of sight. So the eyes are large and optic lobes are well developed due to acute vision. So the sense of smell, it is poorly developed, corresponding the ill development of the olfactory lobes. So in birds, we can see optic lobes are well developed, whereas olfactory lobes are poorly developed. The 10th anatomical adaptation related to reproductive system. In female birds, the presence of single functional ovary on left side, it leads to reduction of the body weight, which is essential for flight. So thus it becomes evident that the birds are fully developed for terrestrial, arboreal and aerial environments. Thank you. Stay home, stay safe. If you are watching my video for the first time, please subscribe my channel.